And welcome back to Hadoop Exam Learning Resources. Now in this session we will cover the next questions from the, our Hadoop Exams Databricks Spark Developer Certification, that is on version Spark version 2.x. okay, 2.x means any version after 2.1 2.2 2.3, kind of thing. Okay, so let me start we will be covering this time quite a small question, but certainly there is a chance to get this question in the exam. Okay, so it's a basic conceptual questions, what exactly the Spark does behind the scene, kind of thing. So let's see. You have been given below code assume hadoop-exam.txt file and can be easily fit into this memory. This statement is very important. Okay, this file can easily fit into the memory. So now once you run this code, how many times file will be loaded, okay, in memory? That is the question. That's a one time, two time, three times, or four times. Now you need to understand the caching concept here. Okay, so what exactly it does, it reads the file from this location and load into the RDD. So let's go here okay. So what it is doing here is actually in the first step it will create an RDD. okay, so this is not yet executed, this line, correct? This is a transformation, loading the file, but this is an action. Count is an action. So what we are saying here, okay, you apply the count on this, so this file would be loaded here and the count would be applied on this, whatever is data. So one time the file would be loaded and this RDD would be discarded after that. Okay, now you are calling next count function again on the same RDD. So but previous RDD we have discarded, correct? So what it does actually, it again load the file from this location and then do the count. That is what the Spark feature is. If you have like everything like direct acyclic graph and all this concepts, you know, so this has to create this entire graph and execute it once you call the action on the particular RDD. Now here this is a two time file has been loaded and Hadoop exam RDD has been discarded, correct? Now here we are again calling Hadoop exam RDD.cache. Now we don't have RDD yet in memory. So what we will do, again load the file then cache it. Okay, so now this is third time the file is loaded in memory, correct? So that is what here entire explanation is saying here. So now here you can see up to this we have loaded three times the file. Now you are again calling the count on this function, it will not load the file again because you have already cached the RDD. So whatever is available in memory, this RDD, that would be used here. Okay, similarly file will not be loaded here after. So until you unpersist this file or remove from the cache, it will use this RDD again and again. So that is what the main concept here. If you want to use RDD again and again in your code, then you have to cache it. If you are using only one time, then you have to discard it, okay, because there is no point of caching it if you are using a one time. Now the important point in the question was that this file can easily fit into memory. If there is a chance if file cannot fit into the memory, so what, there is no point of it means you cannot cache this file, correct? Because it is bigger than memory, correct? So caching would not help, and again this file would be loaded from the this file system again and again, and this cache would not be advantageous. So that is the very important point you have to remember in the exam. If they say if it is in, it can fit into the memory, then you can consider this. If it cannot fit into the memory, then caching would not helpful. That is what you have to remember. Okay, so that's all about in this session. It was quite small session, but a conceptual session. We wanted to cover the one concept, so that's the reason we have created this. Thanks for watching, and I hope you like this session. If you're watching on YouTube, don't forget to subscribe it. Okay, and I would suggest don't forget to visit the hadoopexam.com. We regularly update or create new material from on regular basis, correct? So, and these are all contact details through which you can connect with us. Thank you. I'm stopping now.